Nearly 40% of Americans can't even last a month on savings. That's a horrible statistic because that means almost half of Americans are living paycheck to paycheck. If 2020 has taught us something, then it's that nothing is guaranteed. You can plan as much as you want, but then something that's entirely out of your control can ruin everything and can even cost you your job. People have spent years building businesses but had to close their doors forever due to the lockdown. But crises aren't always bad. They shake things up and provide an opportunity for everyone to climb to the top in a relatively short time. Think about the number of people who earned a fortune due to the crypto boom. The United States also added 2.2 new millionaires from 2019 to 2020 alone, which puts it at the very top of the list of countries with the most of millionaires. If you are not one of them, then don't worry, because such opportunities come every 5 to 10 years, but you have to be ready for them. In fact, you don't even need such an opportunity to become financially free. In the 21st century, we have so many financial tools that almost anyone can become financially free if they invest early and wisely. And one of them is dividend investing. In 2018, Warren Buffett earned $3.8 billion in dividends. Don't get me wrong, he did not sell his shares, but rather the companies he has invested in paid him that much money. But why? How do dividends work? What kind of stock should you buy to get the highest dividends possible? Are dividend stocks better than rental income? And how to invest in dividend stocks to be able to quit your job? We'll answer all of these questions and many more. But before we do that, make sure to give this video a thumbs up that it deserves, and here is a little disclaimer. This is not financial advice, and everything that's said in this video is for educational and entertainment purposes. And now, let's dive in. Many of you believe that rental income is the best type of passive income, and it's really difficult to disagree with that because the property often keeps rising in value and the rental income is often big enough to cover your needs and wants. Worst case scenario, you can literally live in that house if you don't find a tenant. But the demand for shelter will always be there. Even during the pandemic, when everyone thought that it could greatly damage real estate prices, the exact opposite has happened, where house prices rose by almost 17%. However, managing real estate is not as easy as many people believe. I've been in real estate for years, and it takes a lot of time to keep your rental income coming, which means it's not as easy as many of you might believe. That's what makes dividends so appealing, because dividends are the real passive income. Often, you don't have to do anything once you find the right company to invest in. But what are the dividends in the first place? You see, companies take time to mature and grow up. In the beginning, they need investments to hire people, rent a place, but once they start making a profit, they share that profit with the owners of the company. So, when you buy a stock, the company is obligated to share that profit with you. That is called a dividend. But not all companies pay dividends, especially tech companies. They would rather reinvest that money back into the business to grow faster. But stable companies that don't have much room left to grow usually share that profit with their shareholders, like Coca-Cola, McDonald's, Johnson & Johnson, and so on. But companies like Amazon have a lot of competition, so they never pay a profit, but instead benefit their shareholders by keeping their stock price rising. In order to find out how much dividends does a company pays, just Google the stock price of that company and pay attention to the dividend yield. In this case, Apple pays 0.62% for each stock. In other words, Apple pays 88 cents for each stock you own. That's a lot of money. But if you own enough stocks, that could turn into a substantial amount. But you also have to consider that since the beginning of the pandemic, the Fed lowered interest rates and started buying corporate bonds. So stock prices rose dramatically, some of them doubled within a year, but their dividends still remained the same, which lowered their dividend yield. Prior to the pandemic, Apple, for example, used to pay 2.5% in dividend yields, which means for every $1,000 you invest in Apple, you would receive $2.5. Still, that number doesn't seem as high as you can get in real estate, but you also have to consider that when you invest in dividend stocks, you also benefit from the rise of the stock. In the last 10 years, Apple wasn't just paying dividends, but the price of the stock rose by 1,156%, way more than real estate investors can even dream. But we also have companies that are so-called the king of dividends. There is an elite list of 31 companies that have the longest history of doing so. These are companies that endured through financial storms and difficult markets while still finding a way to increase their dividends each year. There are companies that investors can rely on, such as Johnson & Johnson. For 59 years, it has kept raising its dividends. As of this year, it pays 2.54% in dividends, which is $4.24 a year. Which means if you own $100,000 worth of Johnson & Johnson stocks, you will receive a dividend payment of $2,540 every single year. Of course, on top of that, you will gain from the rise of the stock price. My other favorite dividend stocks are Coca-Cola, that pays over 3% in dividends. It's a well-established company that doesn't seem to shrink in the next few decades. Do you really believe that in the coming future, people will stop drinking cola? I don't think so. That's why for 59 years in a row, it kept increasing its dividend payment. Other notable companies are Lowe's, Procter & Gamble, Universal Corporation. I will leave a link to the list of these companies for those who are interested. But the main question is, how much money should you invest to live off dividends and retire? Before we answer that question, we have to figure out how much do you spend per year. $40,000, $50,000, $60,000. That number is going to be different for everyone, but let's take $50,000. In order to make $50,000 a year, you should buy $2 million worth of dividend stocks if we take an average of 2.5% dividend yield. Of course, there are dividend stocks that pay way better, but they're riskier. With King of Dividends, you can sleep calmly because these companies are so big and well-established that even 10 years from now, they will probably be bigger and pay more dividends. While when it comes to smaller companies that pay 6 or 7%, they could plummet. In fact, one way companies attract investors when they're doing terrible financially is by paying high dividends. You will get a higher dividend yield, but as the stock price keeps falling, you will lose on the other side. So never invest in a company just because it pays a higher dividend yield. And never invest in just one company, regardless of how stable the company is, because like any other company, it could go bankrupt. Of course, the idea of Coca-Cola going bankrupt seems impossible because it has been around since the 19th century, but everything is possible, so never put all of your eggs in just one basket. Of course, you can get a higher yield if you invest in real estate, such as 5, 7 or even 10% if you find a good deal in the market. But in order to get into real estate, you need a lot of money. Even if you are taking a mortgage, you need to make the down payment first. Then you have to spend weeks, if not months, to find a good deal in the market. And even assuming that you get all of that right, real estate needs a certain level of management. Finding a tenant, something always breaks down, so you have to fix it, and so on. But when it comes to dividends, there are well-known dividend stocks that you can invest in without all of that hassle. But with dividend stocks, you can start with as little as $100. On top of that, if you want to liquidate your stocks, then it's much easier than selling a house. I'm not a really big fan of dividend stocks because you could make way more by investing in growth stocks than you could possibly make from dividend stocks. In the last 10 years, Amazon stock rose by 2,500%. Facebook grew by 780% since 2012. Microsoft grew by almost 900%. Netflix grew by 3,000%. If you put the effort to find one or two great tech stocks, you can make way more than you could possibly make from dividend stocks. And once you have built some wealth, you can invest part of that income to create passive income. But before you start investing in the stock market, you have to understand the basics of the stock market. You have to learn how to read financial statements, analyze companies, and read between the lines. That's why I created a short animated course on Skillshare that will teach you everything you need to learn about the stock market. The entire course is animated from the top to the bottom and explained so simply that even if you know nothing about the stock market, you will become an expert. The first 100 of you to use the link in the description will get a 2 weeks of Skillshare Premium and will be able to watch the course for free. At the end of the course, there will be an assignment that you have to complete, and I will personally check your assignment and provide you with the feedback. And now, give this video a thumbs up that it deserves and make sure to subscribe if you haven't done that yet. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.